more than two dozen U.S. bishops and priests of Cuban descent have sent a video message to those protesting the country's communist government. Bishop Manuel Aurelio Cruz, the Cuban-American Auxiliary Bishop of the Archdiocese of Newark, New Jersey, said in part, quote, "I know the pain, the suffering of our people, and the time has come for our homeland to have freedom. Our Lady of Charity, save our Cuban people. Amen." And joining us now is Grazie Christie, Policy Advisor for the Catholic Association and host of EWTN Radio's Conversations with Consequences. Grazie, thank you so much for joining us. Always so good to be with you. I know as a Cuban-American that you've been following very closely what's been going on in Cuba. Can you give us an update on what's happening in the country right now? And also, do you have any news on those protesters who were arrested earlier this month?
So the country now is heavily militarized. The streets are all being controlled very heavily. People are not safe to go outside and protest anymore. The internet has been shut down completely. There were some ways of getting out if you used a virtual public tunnel, for instance, but now they've even cracked down on that. So we're getting very little news out of the island. There was lots of news of people being arrested at home, young people being torn out of their homes simply for having gone to a protest or having information on their phone that they were sharing. So they are controlling everything very strongly, and I'm sure people are being tortured and lots of people have disappeared.
Well, I know you're in Florida right now, where there are more Cuban Americans than any other area in the United States. What are people saying there about the recent developments in Cuba, and also what would they like to see happen, and the U.S.'s response?
Well, here in Miami, we feel very connected to our brothers and sisters in Cuba. Many of us have family there. All of us have history and a heart full of love for them. And we admire them very much, because the fact that when they go out into the street and protest, they take their lives into their hands and the lives of their families. So we know they've hit rock bottom. We would like the entire global community to turn their backs on the Cuban regime, because any support that they get goes straight to the strength that they have in oppressing the people. We need the entire world community to turn their backs on them.
Yeah, and we've seen a lot of protests in Florida, and also just yesterday in Washington, D.C., thousands of people came out in support of Cuba. As you know, several of the bishops and priests in the video that we had just mentioned earlier made reference to Our Lady of Charity. Can you talk to us more about Our Lady and the role that she plays in Cuba among the people and also in the church?
So before the revolution, Cuba was a very Catholic country. Over 99% of the people were Catholic, very devout. And Our Lady of Charity has been the patroness of Cuba for over 500 years. She appeared to three young boys who were about to drown in the ocean in their little boat, and she saved them. And she's a person that the Cuban people, we carry her in our hearts with so much devotion and love, whether we're in Cuba or we're here. And we pray to her all the time that as she saved her sons 500 years ago, she will come again and save her Cuban children.
Yeah, and Grazie, before we let you go, where do you see this all going? I mean, how do you see this playing out in Cuba?
You know, with all the hope in my heart, I will say that this is unprecedented, the amount of desperation in the people. They can no longer stand it. You know, COVID and all the illness that it has brought to the island, and the fact that there's no real medical care for them, and of course no vaccines or no food, has brought them out into the streets. And we pray for them, and I think there's hope that there could be a regime change, but I think it will take the United States and other countries to support the people of Cuba.
Grazie, thank you so much for weighing in, and we too will continue praying for the people of Cuba. Grazie Christie, Policy Advisor for the Catholic Association and host of EWTN Radio's Conversations with Consequences. Thank you again.
Thank you.